The ICEVI, the Nippon Foundation Mathematics Package for Teachers. Title of the video, Proper Fractions. We had already explained the concept of part and whole and explained how fraction is treated as a part of the whole. Now we have to teach the concept of proper fraction. Proper fraction is a fraction where the numerator is less than the denominator. Whenever the numerator is less than the denominator, we call that as a proper fraction. We have to teach the concept of improper fraction, mixed fraction, etc. You know, for that we can develop the concept of fraction bar. Now, fraction has two parts, numerator and the denominator. Now here we are taking this paper strip and folding it to make different sections. So this paper strip has been folded in such a way that we are making 8 sections. Now for young children we can start with few sections, and for grown-up children we can have more sections. Now this strip is indicating the denominator. Now we can use another strip to indicate the numerator. So again we can fold this strip into 8 sections to indicate 8 place values. Now you can unfold this and then you can have 8 sections. You know, we are using different colors, you know, so that it will be helpful for sighted children too. Now one strip is indicating the numerator and the other strip is indicating the denominator. Now it is useful if they are staying together. So what we do, we make a simple adaptation, take the strip and paste it on a cello tape in such a way that the denominator is below the numerator, and then paste it in one end of the strip. So now you have a strip. One is indicating the numerator and the other is indicating the denominator. Now it is very easy to develop the concept of proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fraction, etc. Now ask the child to form a fraction 5 by 8. 5 by 8. Now you can keep the number 5 and a bar and a number 8 below to explain the concept how the fraction is indicated visually. Now this is a proper fraction because the numerator is less than the denominator. You know, these numbers have braille markings too, so that will help the child to understand it clearly. Now ask the child to form the fraction in the tactile bar. You know, that will help the child to understand the position and also a concept of how the 5 portions will feel in the total of 8 portions, right? Now let the child count from the left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the remaining portion can be folded inside. The remaining portion can be folded inside. Now on top there are 5 places. At the bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This will give an idea to the child what is the value of 5 divided by 8. So 8, this is 5, that means it is, the midway is 4, that is 5 is more than the midpoint. Let us ask the child to make a fraction 4 by 7. 4 by 7. Now let the child start from the left, go to the numerator step. 1 2 3 4 4. So let the child fold the remaining places inside. So that means on the top the child gets 1 2 3 4. Now go to the denominator. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. That means one place should be folded inside, so that will make 4 by 7. Here when we just present the numbers, it gives an idea of whether the fraction is a proper fraction or improper fraction, etc. But in the tactile way, the child will be able to guess the value of the fraction also. Let us see how, you know, this can be taught when you are using higher numbers. You know, suppose we take the number, let us say 16. 16 in the denominator and 8 in the numerator. Now ask the child to form 8 places in the numerator. Let the child count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So let the child fold the paper inside and keep 8 places in the numerator. And similarly, you know, suppose you want the child to make a fraction of 8 by 15. 8 by 15. Now what happens, you know, let the child 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Now 15 means 1 2 3 and final 16, and the child fold one place inside and make it as 8 by 15. So this way the child will be able to make any number of fractions using the fraction bar, which will help the child to understand the value also. Now you can notice that the proper fraction is always less than 1. Proper fraction is always less than 1. Again, that can be taught to the child using this fraction bar. So the numerator is 16, the denominator is 16. That means 16 by 16, it is 1. So when you have a proper fraction, it should be in such a way that the numerator is less than the denominator. So that means even if you take 15 places in the numerator, the child will understand that the denominator has one more place. The denominator here, by the length of the strip also, the denominator is longer than the numerator. So this way the child will clearly understand the concept of proper fraction using this fraction bar.